very warm welcome to our service. Whatever sort of day, week, month you've had, consider yourself welcomed into the Lord's family as we worship him now. Together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. And the second is this: love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Therefore, let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry, and we repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Collect. The Collect for the ninth week after Trinity. Almighty God, who sent your Holy Spirit to be the life and light of your Church, open our hearts to the riches of your grace, that we may bring forth the fruits of the Spirit in love and joy and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the prophecy of Jeremiah. It's Jeremiah chapter 31. The Lord says, I will be the God of all the families of Israel. They shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. When Israel sought for rest, the Lord appeared to him from far away. I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore I have continued my faithfulness to you. Again I will build you. You shall be built, O Virgin Israel. Again you shall take your tambourines and go forth in the dance of the merrymakers. Again you shall plant vineyards on the mountains of Samaria. The planter shall plant and shall enjoy the fruit, for there shall be a day when sentinels will call in the hill country of Ephraim, come, let us go up to Zion, to the Lord our God. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, save the remnant of Israel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 130. Praise the Lord. Praise, O servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from this time on and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to its setting, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, his glory above the heavens. Who is like the Lord our God, who is seated on high, who looks down on the heavens and the earth? He raises the poor from the dust, and lift the needy from the ash heap, to make them sit with the princes of his people. He gives barren woman a home, making her the joyous mother of children. Praise the Lord.
District of Tyre and Sidon, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon," but he did not answer at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting at us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's tables." And then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the daughter was healed instantly.
I've got a mobile phone. A miracle of modern technology. There. I can talk to someone on the other side of the world, someone completely invisible, but I can talk to them through the agency of my phone here. The way it works is very straightforward. The person on the other side of the world speaks, I can speak back. And as an intermediary, there's a satellite high, high, high above the sky talking in radio waves. That satellite is an intermediary because it translates what I say, retranslates it back at the other end, back and forth and back and forth, and so the conversation continues. All I need to do is put the phone against my ear, the other person has their phone, and the radio waves do all the work for us. It's a very good way of thinking about prayer. Prayer, what's prayer? I'm not talking about a list of complaints to an absent God. No, I'm talking about real prayer. Communicating with God. Communicating in a proper conversation. Getting to know God. Building that relationship of faith. There is God in heaven. I can't see him. Here I am on earth. And the intermediary in this case is not a radio wave. The intermediary is God the Holy Spirit. God the Holy Spirit living, residing at the same time in heaven and down here. So using the analogy of a mobile phone, how does prayer work? Well, simple really. Firstly, I've got to turn it on. If my phone is not on, there's no way I'm going to hear what someone on the other side of the world, the other side of town, is going to say. Off, on, off, on. Unless the phone is switched on, It's totally pointless in even starting that conversation. And in the same way, when we're talking to God, we need to turn on the spiritual part of our nature. If we're living in gross sin or simply ignoring God, why on earth are we trying to talk to him? We put our human nature into the hands of God. We switch on our spiritual side. But even if it's switched on, I can't hear it if it's over here, or over here, or down here. I need to bring it closer and closer and closer to my ear. In the same way, I've got to bring God closer to my heart. Or perhaps the better analogy, bring my heart to him. Because if I'm far away from God, living in a way that doesn't really seem spiritual at all, it's more difficult to hear what he's saying. And thirdly, imagine I'm trying that conversation and there's a loudspeaker next to me, or a pneumatic drill, or a mind full of little irrelevances. I need to still that other noise. Even with a phone against my ear, I'm not going to hear it. We need to still our heart. Jesus, when he talks about prayer, talks about us going into a quiet room, closing the door. That way we can concentrate on him. Prayer. It's the essence of a spiritual life. We're built to pray. God wants us to. He's yearning to talk to us as well as us talk to him. Like a phone, switch on your spiritual nature. Get close to God. And then get rid of everything else, the distractions. Start that conversation. Get to know God. Listen. We now affirm our faith using the words of the Creed. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, the source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Joy at the work of your hands. cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord on the earth, let us sing. Bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hand. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have. King, mountains bow down and the seas roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hand. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have in you.
Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, teach us how to pray. Teach us how to turn on our spiritual nature. Help us to get close to you. Help us when we're distracted to get rid of those distractions and concentrate our entire life, our soul, on you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we pray for your church. Let it be a listening church, a church in relationship with you, a church that serves you, does everything it can to please you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for the world, all of it. We remember that you created the world and it was good. So we pray for the bits of the world that now are not good, that they can come back to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we pray for ourselves, our friends, our families, people we know or live next to, work with. And in a moment of silence, we're going to bring them into your loving presence and ask you to help them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Father, we pray for folk who've died. People we know of and people that only you know about. People who've passed from this world to the next. Their families, their friends. And we ask that you will help all of them in their grief. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we gather together all these prayers using the words that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours, Lord, is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We now bow our heads to receive the blessing of God the Almighty. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God the Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. Hope you've had a good week. We'll continue to pray for you, and please, if you have the time, pray for us.